Okay, so today we're going to be creating an application using Visual Basic that tracks the weather, and it uses live text feeds coming from Yahoo, and all of the code comes from a book called In Easy Steps. All right, let's get started. So open up Visual Basic, click on New Project, make sure you have Windows Form selected, and call it Weather App. You should see a form. On that form, you're going to add a button. Then after the button, you're going to add a text box right next to it. Above the text box, you're going to put a label, and you're going to change the text property for that label to say, type your zip code. The text box that you created, you're going to change the property name to say zip code. We're also going to add a group box, and we're going to put it on the form. We're going to change the text of the group box one to say, how's the weather? Then you're gonna go to my website and you're gonna copy some code and paste that into the button. So double click on that button, paste that in there. So that's the code for that button. Now we're gonna run the application. Okay, so type in your zip code. Press on that button and notice group box one changing to Yahoo weather and then your town. So we know this is working. Now we're going to add a label and we're going to change the text of that label to say climate. Then we're going to add two more labels. The second label that you're going to add, the text, you're going to change it to temperature. The last one, you're going to change the text to humidity. After the labels, you're going to add three text boxes. The first text box, you're going to change the name property to climate. The second text box, you're going to change the name property to temperature. And the last text box, the name property has to be humidity. Then you're going to go back to my website and copy some more code that came straight from that book in easy steps. After you copy the code, go back into the application, double click on the go button, and after where you pasted the first part, you're going to paste the second part. So right after inner text, press return, then paste the code in there. If you get an error message saying string constants must end with a double quote, you need to go back to the second double quote of the website. And then replace it, and that should take care of the problem. Okay, then run it. You type in a zip code, and you notice that all the text boxes populate. So it looks like it's working. But what happens when you put in a whole bunch of ones in there? The application will freak out and give you an error message. So we're going to need an error handler. Okay, so click on that link to go back to my website. Copy the code that starts with if group box 1.txt. Then go back to the application and under group box 1.txt, paste the code. Now the application knows what to do when it encounters an error. We just need to copy two more lines of code and we'll paste those right before the end of the button one click procedure. You're going to get error messages saying that label 5 and label 6 are not declared. And that's because I added code for two labels that do not exist yet. So we're going to add them. Click on Form View, then choose the label from the toolbox and spread it across the form inside of group box 1. Do the same for label 6. Once you add label 5 and label 6 to the form, you should see the errors disappear. So we'll run it and see what we get. Label 5 and label 6 are not supposed to be visible. They're only supposed to come up after you put in a zip code. So we'll have to fix that. So stop the application and go back to my website. And you're going to copy some more code where it says code 5. And you're going to paste that right above the ended procedure. Okay, so go back to the application. And there's the button 1 procedure. So we'll look for the ended function. There it is. And we'll paste this right above the ended function. Okay, in order to fix label 5 and label 6 from being seen at the beginning, we're going to change their property visible to be false. We also don't want the user to be inputting text into any of the climate temperature or humidity boxes. So we're going to select them by holding down Control and then going to the Enable property and choosing false. Now when you run it, you'll notice that the climate temperature and humidity text boxes are grayed out. When you type a zip code, it gives you the proper info. And when you type an incorrect zip, it gives you an error message. So everything is working according to plan. Excellent. If you like this video, make sure you click on that like button and subscribe to my channel to find out when the exciting conclusion to the weather app comes out. Thank you for watching.